Everybody, welcome to my kitchen. My name is Diane and I want to show you today how I clean and cut corn off the cob and cook it the easy way. I go through a lot of corn in the summer because I take it off the cob for quite a few people. Teeth issue when you get older. Plus, you want to know this if you want to can, but I don't really like canning it. I prefer to cut it off the cob and freeze it. Anyway, let me show you how to do this. What we're gonna do, the easiest way, and I do a lot of this, is to take your whole cob. I'm going to, for intent and purpose of doing this inside of my microwave, cut the stem end off so that it fits the microwave. And I might trim a couple of these back. One ear is gonna go into the microwave for quick eating purpose for 5 minutes. Two ears that you would put side by side, but the fatter in this way, for 8 minutes. And then I'll show you what happens when it comes out. Now, if you're gonna do this in an oven, set your oven at 400 and then put them on a sheet tray and line them up every other one. And they'll go in for about 20 minutes to a half hour. Try and leave a little space behind them. And then I like to do them on the grill too, because on the grill, they get a little smoky kind of flavor, but don't do them on direct heat. Do it offset a little bit. And probably takes about a half hour on the grill. Much like chicken with bones, corn with the husks adds so much flavor. Plus, if you're entertaining or you know you need another 20 minutes before everybody's gonna sit down and eat, the husk also keeps it nice and warm so you can get lots of butter. I don't know what you eat more of, the corn or the butter, but anyway, I'm gonna put this in the microwave and then I'll show you a really easy way to clean it. Be right back. All right, it's been 5 minutes. Now, I'll show you how easy this is. Could be a little hot coming off the grill, the microwave, whatever. You might have to hold this in a towel. My hands are used to it. But what happens when you do it in the microwave oven or the grill and leave the silk on and the husks on, other than, of course, great flavor, the steam builds up in the husk. Even when it's grilled, it does. Then you take the corn, you rip it back, and just take it out of the husk. There's not a silk on it. It's pretty fast. Then after that, what we want to do is, you might want to eat it on the cob until you're sick of doing that. You might want to make a great corn casserole. The easiest way I found to do this, now I will say that I like to do it in the sink because it saves a big mess. But having said that, I could be doing it on the cutting board. We'll see how this goes. I usually don't use a bowl this size. I use a bigger one, but I wanted to use a glass one. You stand the corn up on its end and you just run a knife down the cob at about maybe a 10 degree angle, that's it. You just let the knife, much like filleting a piece of fish, just let the knife glide down the bone. Now by putting it on, I like this 1 pound deli container because it's the right height to keep this off the bowl edge to save your knife. And after you do about a, you know, maybe 6 of them or so, you'll see that this goes really fast. Now what I do with the cob is, if you have time, I like to scrape the cob with the back of the knife and make sure you get it all. Then the cob itself, you could put in a pot with minimal water to cover, probably by an inch or so, and then boil them. And in the winter when you want to make a corn chowder or use it as a base for any kind of vegetarian soup, oh, it's heaven. Now, where to go get your corn? It's available everywhere. You're better off buying corn, sweet corn, at a farm stand or from a farmer you know, like the Toledo Farmers Market if you're in the 419 area or Michigan area. Or just take a drive around the country. There's farm stands everywhere. But I like to get to know a farmer because I like sweet corn. The best way to freeze this, I found, is in about 2 pound containers, packages. Freeze it in a food saver bag. The food saver gets all the air out so that you don't end up with corn that has freezer burn all over it, because I guarantee you're not going to use it. Get some kind of vacuum sealer to make nice little packages. Make sure you date them before they go to the freezer. But anyway, that's the fastest way I found to do a corn. I can go through about 60 years after it's cooked, probably about a half hour, because it's that fast. Not cleaning it, but at least getting it husked. So I hope you give that a whirl. To have some corn in the winter is really a wonderful thing in January, or to add to a stew, anything. All right, let me show you the second year real quick. Again, 5 minutes in the microwave, or it could have been in the oven or on the grill. Take the silk by the top, pull it down and off, and break off the bottom. Hot, very hot. Towel would be in order. Not one silk left on it. Pretty easy. Then again, stand it up on your container. And like I say, the sink is really a nifty way to go. It saves a big mess. And the knife gliding down the cob, very hot. Give this a turn or two. And if you live in the country and you have critters, you could also save a couple ears that you don't clean completely for the critters. Chucky, I think I'm gonna feed him a couple, but anyway, cleaning this off a bit. Scrape the ear, because no matter what I do, I really like the little bit that's left on the cob. So depending on how big the ears are, you can bet on about a cup and a half per ear of corn. I like to do at least about 5 dozen anyway. There you have a really easy way to prepare some corn, get it ready for the freezer, or eat right away. I hope you give that a whirl. Leave comments, like this video, share with your friends, and stay tuned for more. The next one I'm going to do is on the tomato pie. This is a great weekend to be canning and preserving. It's Labor Day. Come down to the Toledo Farmers Market and stock up. Great, perfect weekend for canning, freezing, and doing anything in the kitchen to preserve the harvest. Thanks for joining me.